Well, our goal is always to make food grade quality oats. And a portion of that is making sure we have good quality and high test weight. So we learn to try to adjust the combine settings to be able to allow for preservation of the good quality stuff and let some of the lighter stuff go out. So a lot of times that's just retesting over and over, trying to validate what test weight we're coming out. Usually we're shooting a little bit under what the standard is, because by the time we finish harvesting and running it through augers and grain dryers or just handling in general, we'll pick up a few more pounds of test weight. So if we target close to that 35, 36 pounds, we usually end up at 38 pound test weight, 37, 38. I'm not sure that's a guarantee all the time, but it seems to work for us.
So here is a sample of some of the oats that we've harvested on our farm. Depending on the end use for the oats, so these oats came right out of our bin recently. We recently sold a load of oats to a local farmer who wanted some to mix into some cattle feed on his farm, and he didn't require any additional cleaning than the cleaning that the oats received from the combine before they went into the bin. But depending on the end user, that may require you to do more or less processing and cleaning in order to get into that market. Like we've found with horse owners that some of them will take oats just like this cattle farmer did. Others want them to be very, very clean and free of dust. And so one of the things that we are in the process of doing is slowly locating and acquiring some usable cleaning equipment for the grain so that we can do additional levels of cleaning to it before we put it in bags or put it on a truck or a wagon to sell to somebody in bulk. And there again, finding that type of equipment is really challenging. There isn't a lot of it out there anymore. To buy it new is very cost prohibitive. So you kind of have to go on a treasure hunt sometimes to find some of those things in the used market.
We will take it to our grain facility or a grain site, and we'll auger it into a wet bin. From the wet bin, we'll auger it into a dryer. It'll come through the dryer. We'll put a little air on it and just let kind of that whole process kind of polish up the oats a little bit. Then we use an air system to blow it to a bin. And when we blow it to the bin, there's a cyclone on the top of our bin. It lets a lot of the dust and some of the lighter stuff continue to blow out. So, you know, all those things together kind of help continue to bring out the chaff, the light stuff. And then when we remove the oats from the bin as well, either we use a grain vac or we'll use our existing air system. We'll transfer it to a holding bin. It's kind of a little bit involved, but just the process of using air, either grain vac or some other air system to kind of continue to separate the light stuff from the heavy stuff, just seems to continue to bring the test weight up to a good place. So
those oats are, the test weight on those oats is between 38 and 40 pounds. One of the things that we hear a lot from about oats is test weight, and you know, one of the reasons that so many of the oats are grown in the northern United States and Canada today is because, in large part due to their climate up there, they have a much easier time more consistently raising oats that have higher levels of test weight. And one of the things we need to understand about that is that the level of test weight, it doesn't necessarily mean the same thing to every end user. There are some situations where higher and higher levels of test weights are very desirable, but there are other situations too where an oat that maybe doesn't have the highest levels of test weight is more than adequate, or even desirable, more desirable than the higher test weight oat depending on the animal you're feeding it to and the application. Like the very high test weight oats, they tend to be desired and preferred by people that have like racehorses, that have oats, or that have horses that are doing things that are very physically demanding, requiring a lot in terms of energy. But for horses that are used for trail riding, for cattle and hogs, the oats that we're able to consistently grow here in Iowa are way more than adequate in terms of their quality.